mentioned earlier, Birdie Reese are getting the start tonight. 14 games this year, he's 14-7-1 with a 4.25 goals against average and an 88.7 save percentage. Has seen action once this year, and we've got a goal already. Baker in on the left side. Just glanced up and saw Baker coming down the left wing, almost unmolested, taking a shot, beating goaltender, which we haven't even introduced yet, Craig Wood, to his glove side. And the Rockets took an early 1-0 lead. 3.69 goals against average and an 89.5% save percentage against the Lincolns. Craig Wood, despite the fact he's seen most of the games this season for the Lincolns, has only appeared in one game against the Rockets this season. In 23 games, he's 7-11-2 with a 4.01 goals against average and an 88.4 save percentage. Since the trading deadline, that was a 6-4 win for the Rockets. They really had to work for that win for the Lincolns, and a break down the right side for St. Mary's. In their own end zone. Quite often the puck will go in the corner and everybody else looks, not knowing who's supposed to go for it. Thank you. was seeing a little patchwork by the Rockets there with their forward lines this evening. This was when they'd be very difficult to get an opportunity in a power play, but their best players on the ice. and they're as good as anybody else with that first line that they've got. Shot from the point, and Norby keeps it nice and low, and he has a nice typical shot as well. Couldn't get that one through the rocket pounder color, and he's leading the rush. Some good work along the boards by the Rockets. That was O'Neal, very, very active with the stick, able to poke the puck out the stick just long enough for the Rockets to clear the zone. One of the APJs they've called up from the Lucan Irish, getting some nice power play time here. It was a nice move when he walked over the corner. Has been at every game. He is on the bus again here with the boys tonight. He's been very supportive, even though he's been out with this concussion that sidelined him for such a long time. We certainly hope that Mike Mangarelli, also receiving a concussion on that game in the weekend, won't be out near as long. We're certainly keeping our fingers crossed on that. Very active there, coming over this net, knowing that his defensemen were not in a good position, able to corral that puck and slow down the Lincoln's attack, and now Lincoln's going for a line change, Rockets able to regroup.
Thank you.
something a little different here in their power play. Give an opportunity here with a team that has a very weak penalty kill. But despite the weak penalty kill, the St. Mary's Lincolns have scored 9 shorthanded goals this year. So they are very dangerous. And I think that's the reason the team's taking a little bit to liberty. And here's Jordan on the left side.
Thank you.
players that are no longer with this club that have more points. Side there by the Lincolns. You make one false pass and on a power play, it's going to cost you. They're going to have to regroup and start all over again, and that's what the St. Mary's Lincolns are doing, straight up the ice. A lot of calls for that from Chris tonight saying, didn't see it. It's just like the Lincolns just aren't on the same page with each other. And that's to be expected when there's a lot of call-ups in the lineup and everyone's not familiar with playing with each other. As I said, they've had 18 different call-ups. I'm guessing at the end of the season, the St. Mary's Lincolns are going to have to award their scoring championship trophy to a player who's no longer with the club. Oh, boy. I don't know what you do in that. I mean, what do you do at your awards banquet? You present your scoring leader trophy to someone who's not with you anymore? It'd be odd. You'd have to. Current player that's still with him. Yeah, which would be Penny at the moment, yes. There's left just before the blue line and putting the bomb in. Oh! Nice, and very nice defending there by the Lincolns. They really had the Rockets bobbled up along the left wall there. They really were trying to get it over to the other side where there was more bodies, but they were outmanned. It seemed to have every opportunity. Change lines during the power play because most of their bench is right inside the blue line. Well, that's exactly the play they've made. Rockets now lead. Skating back towards center, I thought that it was a goal, but that was not the case. Still 3-0, and we still have 28 seconds left in 4-on-4. I've been watching games in this league, I think, for 19 years now, and Bill Way's been a part of that right from the start, so it's going to be a huge loss for this hockey, for this entire hockey league to have Bill Way. And whenever you think about Southern Cup games and you think about getting key officials in here, this is the referee that everybody wants. Typically, I mean, usually it's just a couple hundred dollars or something for a player. It doesn't mean a lot, but, well, we'll see. Stick and skates are Duard able to make to the make it to the bench for a line change. Boyer on to take his place. Sprint down the ice, but he thought it was more important to get to the bench for a change, get some fresh bodies on the ice, and that's a good, responsible play from the Rocket captain. And the referee says nope, gotta stay on the bench. Pyramid Rec Center in St. Mary's.
Thank you.
the Christmas break there. Watson called up to Kingston and Duke on Ottawa. They had to play a game against each other. So here we are, teammates here and OHL opponents during the Christmas break. Kings had a stellar month here for the Rockets. He's been selected as the Rockets player of the game in the last three games. Back and scoring a power play of their own. King getting the marker here. And the Rockets now are pretty comfortable to form up the lead here in St. Mary's. Taking wax out of one on either side of Weiss and kind of hopped over his shoulder, rolled behind him, and the Rockets were not able to pull it out. So that's right. Now he's only 5 points back from time. Jackson on the ice, you got to be thinking of fights, and the OHA has set their limit this year. It's kind of a floating limit with regards to how many fights you're going to have in a season before they start handing out suspensions, and it's 7 this year. So all the teams will be adding up their fights. If you pass the bar, then of course you're in a suspension situation. I think, you know, they were Dan Gibson talking to Jackson prior to the game. He thought he was at 6, but they're going to have to go through and have a look and see exactly how many fights he's had thus far this season. How the Lincolns didn't get that puck in the net. It just looked like a simple tap on the side. Someone must have had their stick on the Lincolns' shaft or something, able to redirect that puck. Almost cut this lead in half. Still 4-1 Rockets, 2:22 left. To cut this lead in half before the period's over. 1:46 left in the period, 1:53 left in the Lincolns power play. That's the right team. Mitchell. interesting. Ah, so who finishes the season as that team, representing that team? Mm-hmm. Well, of course, I mean, that makes sense, because if the player that was traded away, he could end up being a scoring leader on two different teams. That wouldn't make any sense. Yeah. He's reacting there. He's laughing at that one. He was trying to be careful. Lincolns are crawling back into this hockey game. That's going to make it 4-2 for the Rockets. A 4-0 lead, evaporated by two goals pretty quickly, 35 seconds away from our second intermission. Remaining on the clock. Face off to Wiese's left here, deep in the Rocket zone. McDonald jumping in. What a tremendous anticipation on that play. The Rocket just standing around watching that one, not reacting at all. And picking up McDonald coming in, it was almost like he was the point man on the play. Swooped in, looked for the rebound. The timing was just perfect. And hey, they got time for another one. Can they tie this thing up before the period's over? Let's have a look. By one here, 19-14. We'll have lots of time to play here in the third period. Here Yes, they were, and they got regrouped very, very well. In fact, LaSalle 8-2 in their last 10 games. They've been the hottest team here in the West. Defensive club in the entire West knocked them off and then beat the top offensive club in Sarnia and eventually succumbed to the London Nationals, a third place team in the finals. I think only the second time a third place team has captured the championship here. It's we used to call it the seat of death for finishing in third place because so seldom did a third place, third seeded team ever win the championship. Killer power play. They've got five very skilled players that can put on that power play, put them in an odd man situation. They got a great chance of scoring. There's a long stretch pass down the ice, a quick shot, beating goaltender Wood glove side. And boy, right now, that's the difference. Celebrating his 19th birthday on the weekend, and certainly had a rough birthday present, that's for sure, with the tough game that we had against the Lincoln Flyers. Taking any time, chance here with a long pass, and the Lincolns are hoping to get icing on that if they can. Thank you. have to go back and regroup here. 1:39 left in the power play. 11:53 in regulation time. Rockets up by one. It's an opportunity to put some fresh penalty killers on the ice, and they change up the forward lines, and I believe keep the D on as the same. Nope, I'm going to go back and kill a penalty. So he stayed on for the rest of the penalty kill. He's being attended to by trainer Mike Brooks. And just 29 ticks left here on this power play for St. Mary's, one that they desperately need to convert on. I don't know how many more chances they're going to get before this hockey game's over. Continues to march on in this game. Be the turning point of the game. If Lincolns can kill this off and come back and tie this game up. Thank you. fans looking at the clock behind them all the time. 7 minutes exactly remaining here in regulation time in the third period. Lincoln's down by one to the Rockets. Rockets scoring four straight, then the Lincolns with three straight. Will there be any more? Let's find out. Assist on that one as well. You can have a goal and three assists. That line absolutely dynamite for the St. Mary's Lincolns. They have tied this up. JHL, they're 4-0 in shootouts and the best shootout percentage at 53.3%. Snake bitten a bit on the score sheet. He was able to get a big one. He got the tiebreaker. That's after battling back in a 4-0 deficit. The side tie things up. The Rockets take the lead. Tournament as well. He's an incredibly acrobatic goaltender.
Oh,
puck down, trying to put enough weight on it. 4 seconds remaining. First. Telling the defensemen to keep their eye open for the goalie coming, that they could have an empty net behind them pretty soon. Sevens, what they got to play with to tie this game up. Now to the right of Weiss.